This is Sharon, and what I'm going to do today is I'm going to actually refinish this old table. This table has been around for probably over, we've had it for 20 plus years, and it has got a Formica top on it. So a lot of people want to know, can you repaint Formica or laminate? And I'm going to actually show you how that's done to make the paint stick and adhere so that it doesn't come up.
So this is the table. It is a Formica table. So the wood is natural on the bottom, but the top surface is all Formica. This is gonna work the same way if you have a laminate. So first off, clean the surface completely. Next, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and scuff this all up with a light adhesive padding. So you can either use a tool to do this or just use a soft sanding paper, and just enough to scuff it up so that the primer, which is what I'm going to use, will actually adhere and sit to it. Now, the primer that I suggest is by Bin Primer. This one is got a shellac base to it, so it adheres to anything, especially if you're using a laminate or a Formica. This stuff is going to be your golden job here to make sure that the paint will adhere to this type of surface. So give you a good look at that. All right, let's get this project started. I got the drop cloth down. I taped off the edges, which really isn't necessary unless you're going to start painting, but I did it because with the sanding process, I don't want to accidentally hit the wood down here. I really want to focus on just the top. And with the sanding tool that I'm going to use, if it gets too close to the edge, I don't want it to take up this finish. So I may have to retape again when I get ready to paint. But I also separated the table. So depending if you have a dual system, I recommend separating so that you can get a good set of paint over this without basically building up a bubble over the section with the paint or creating a seam that you don't want. All right, now we're ready to buff the table. I've got my little dual tool here. I got light abrasive sanding, and I'm gonna give this a nice little scuff so that the primer paint will actually stick to it. Ready to go? Let's turn it on. Add on your primer. I made sure after sanding that I took a dry cloth, wiped off all the extra powder that I got from doing my sanding across the whole table so that that powder doesn't get stuck into your primer and create lines all over your table. So just wipe all that powder off. Hey guys, now it's time to add the primer. So I got a nice 4-inch sponge roller to add on this primer. And basically what I'm gonna do is just roll this right over here and cover this whole entire table with this white shellac primer. Let this set, and then we'll get ready to add the color. Okay, so now we're to the point where we've added our primer to the whole entire table. So we're just gonna let this go ahead and sit and dry, and then we'll go ahead and add our color. So once again, the material that I'm working with, this is an older table, 20 plus years, and it's actually got Formica on top. So the processes that I've done is I've done a light sanding on top of it, wiped that down, and as you can see, I've taped off because I kind of want to do a two-tone on this. I'm gonna do a black top with a natural wood finish. So I've added my primer to it after I wiped all the dusting off the table, and we'll show you guys what it's going to look like in a little bit here. Okay, my primer is now completely dry, so we are going to add paint.
and I'll give you guys a peek when we start doing the paint. Now for the paint, you want to make sure that you're buying either a paint that is a cabinet type paint or one that's specific for furniture. So I'll show you which one I'm using. Okay, now depending on the paints that you choose are really gonna satisfy with what your outcome of your look's gonna be. So when you pick your paint, I'm using a trim door and furniture paint. This is a deepest black with a high gloss. It's made specifically for furniture. Now, when you're using this, you gotta make sure you pick the right brush, because if you don't pick the right brush, your outcome's not gonna happen the way it's supposed to. This particular glidden paint does ask to use this specific brush, which is the one that I purchased here. So I'll give you a good look at that. And it's supposed to help so it won't have streaks and marks. So let's get this project started. Alright, we're adding our top coat over the primer, which as you can see, this has got a nice beautiful gloss to it, so I can't wait to show you guys the finished product. But keep in mind, like we said, this is actually a Formica table, so those of you who always wondered, can you actually type or paint over Formica, and will it last and will it hold? Here's your answer. Yes.